And what's happening is that the judge, they know in their mind 2 seconds. So when you go down, come on, move. And then you see in UFC when the guy would be like doing too much grappling, I said, come on, move. Hurry up and go. So I think when you, especially with so many arm breaks and all those things, come on, one second. And even if I take them down, we don't want this. Okay, I can take them down. I can resist the heat again. And then move, just like you use standing up.
And so, all the safety equipment is the same that NASA requires for the kids, the face shield and all that. Groin cup, chest pads. Well, I don't think we're going to do the chest pads. I don't know yet. I'm gonna. That's what I was thinking, but I wanted to, again, get advice from the godfathers. And then you have the option to wear. We're going to request that they wear the full padded boxing headgear because that is a lot better than the little vinyl thing just because of the actual takedowns.
You can sweep. No, we're talking, you can do real sweeps.
Okay.
Like the kung fu sweeps, you can sweep.
Yes.
Okay. Yeah. You can sweep. Yeah, and if anybody, you're just going to buy sweep. If they're doing them tackles, you're doing sweepers all over. But you can sweep, but here it goes again. I know when I first did this, I was so nervous. I was just sitting there because I didn't want the white arm to get broke. I didn't want no injuries to happen. That's how the ref got to be. And the ref, and UFC, the ref got to be in shape.
Thinking outside the box a little bit. I think that the one round is good until you get down to the money round. Get down, say, to the last two or
four.
Like the top four.
Now, you've got to fight. You've already been fighting 2 minutes and you're dead tired. But it comes down to, you're not just saying the guy with the best technique is going to win, but also the person that's in the best condition is going to win. And that adds a different element to the fight.
And since we're on this, two things really quick. Inside of your folders are what we have started with the rules. They are on the site. However, again, we want to fine-tune them with as far as like to the top four fighters will fight 2-round eliminations, things like that. If you see something, if you can email me by Sunday, and that way I can get approval, and then we see if it's going to benefit the whole thing, or we can't have rules that benefit one style versus another, or things like that. It's got to be open, because if not, we would just have the whole Kung Fu posse up in here, or the whole type of thing. So I want everybody to feel welcome. The other thing, he talked about him. Like, I know what time tomorrow night is. We got a seminar here during the day. Well, I said, when we go home, we taking the net because John Jones won. I love watching the fighting. I love UFC watching the fighting. The thing I do not like are all the tattoos, the crazy hair, men painting their fingernails, and the language that they use, and the obscenities, and things of that nature. What we are trying to do is to try to control that from becoming a part of this. Because of the reputation of the Capital Classics and Master Run, and I would never do anything to destroy that or begin to step on the toes of that. So we have fight bonus rounds, bonus money for the best technician because we want to see real techniques. We have bonus money for the best sportsmanship and the best fight of the night. The best technique, the best technician, because we want the technique in there. We don't want a bunch of garbage. The sportsmanship, because if he wins, we want to see who is the overall, showing the best example of an athlete. And then best fight of the night is because you want to see action. So we're trying to get the action, but still control the character of the
whole. Like, I'm sorry, how far you want to take this thing?
Well, as far as the industry wanted to go.
No.
I mean, we start out small. It's going to go. I mean, this is what school don't want this? We went to the gym and we said, hey, we want to take MMA to the gym. But it's called Point MMA. I mean, technically, whoa, let's do it. Anything MMA, we going to do. And as a school, I was just telling our staff, we got to do something. Don't get me wrong. I love forms. But I realized when he said we're in an age when people are moving so fast, in 45 minutes, I start realizing that when they start having to become self-conscious and they feel bored and you're doing all this long-winded talking, you start having people drop out from your school because they haven't been around long enough to understand the philosophical side. So I just told them, hold up, during the week, we got to figure out some kind of way where one day it got to just be pads and drills. And on Thursday, it got to be fight night. Because that's what the general public see. Everybody want to fight. Now, if you were school, this is like the double advocate that I see. At one time, you could run a has-been school and not fight. But now the average person looking at UFC, so when they come in, they say, you don't fight?
Mm-hmm.
What? So now, even if you couldn't fight, you better learn how to fight now because the general public wants something related to fighting. In this Lifetime Gym, which has 101 gyms all over the country, if they got, they hire people specifically to teach combat, conditioning, little dragons. I mean, if we don't do something, gyms like that is going to take over. Because they bring in somebody got some professional martial arts.
Out there, buffet, all kinds of stuff. It's like the president's kids have gone there. R. Kelly trains over there. A lot of NBA players train over there.
No.
My question is, okay, on the fighting aspect, I see here where it says the judge can stop a bout if he feels one of the contestants is incapable of continuing. Now, what about accidental injuries like busted lip, busted nose?
Yeah, you can stop that because, you just like in regular point fight, you can stop, and I guess that's also open, so we disqualify the person. So the ref sees that if the ref is really paying attention, he should be able to stop that. Like they said, all those arm breaks, that ref should have stopped that. He should have said, stop, great, but he let him go on. So it takes a ref being close up, and if you see this person getting so intense and getting wild, you stop, calm down. Good sportsmanship. And then you can bring that back under control. And then if they go again, look, okay, it seems like you're not trying to like follow rules. I think it should be a way to automatically disqualify them. Because the key is attitude. The thing that separates this from UFC, we don't want the guys. We don't want a guy showing up with a shirt off. I don't even think they should be fighting with no shirt. Because I don't think it's appropriate to teach a class with an instructor with no shirt on. I'm tying it back to school ownership. I don't want no instructor in here teaching a perm with a shirt off and a tattoo over here. I don't care. I come from the hood, but it ain't happening in this school.
Thank
so
you.
I think if we're trying to be separate, right now, McDonald's, Burger King, all those places are putting money out. Guess what? They looking for that image. And like you said, you don't want that. You don't want, that's not the perfect image for where you're trying to take leadership to. So it's kind of like, let's define, because in actuality, martial arts didn't contradict all what we said we would never do.
Mm-hmm.
We said we would never do this. Now, we're doing what we said we would never do. And some people like, I'm one of them, like, hold up, I thought you said we would never do an ad with somebody kicking somebody in the throat. I thought that wasn't allowed. Now we're putting out ads like that, and mommy's still coming in saying, I don't want my kid to do that. I don't want my oldest son might do it, but I don't want my little son doing it. So I think there's an opportunity for us to control the overall image and character of what a real black belt looks about. That clean cut image of what the sport's supposed to be. And then really the rest are the ones that control them.
But another thing is, what we're also trying to get the convey over to the fighters, we're trying to build your brand. We try to teach you how to sell yourself to make money. Because you are not going to get rich competing in martial arts competitions. You are not going to get a handout from any of these promoters. You got to do it yourself. So we're going to teach you how to do it. We have people in place willing to give you their services through the Point MMA to build you as a prime example. The girl, Ronda Rousey, she just broke the other girl's arm backwards. She owns one part of UFC, but the side thing. But the thing is, they're not making money. So what is she going to make money from? She's on the cover of Black Belt magazine right now. What is she going to make money from? Endorsements, commercials, sports drinks, those kinds of things.